Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Today, a spring training matchup between the New York Yankees and the Minnesota Twins. At the plate, Tyler Wade. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. Slapped hard the opposite way. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. With that, the Yankees have put their leadoff hitter aboard to start out the inning.
Batting seven, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
To the plate now, Gio Urshela. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Now at the plate, DJ LeMahieu.
Second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Throw over to the bag, and he'll dive back in. And another throw over, and a dive, but he's back. And yet another throw over, being especially careful here. He's running down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Hit high and deep out to left field.
Gone!
At the plate, Aaron Judge. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Now this one's crushed. Left field line and foul, though it had the home run distance.
Oh, that's frustrating right there. He was right on that fastball, took it deep, just couldn't keep it fair. How many times have you seen it? There's a good chance he's punching out right here.
Ready with the 1-1. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-1 count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
And he fouls this one off. Working for the punch out and the offering. Breaking pitch, and this bounces in front of the catcher. Diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. But he'll recover to get the force at second. A fantastic play. And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. The 2-1 home.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Now a swing and a fly ball, and it's a foul ball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. Standing in now, Luke Voit. Got him to go after the change there, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count. Do you sit changeup? Or do you stay with the heater?
Here's a fly ball, well hit. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
Batting it, the center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
In now, Aaron Hicks. 1-1 pitch and a nice call for the change. It's 1-2.
I know he's been struggling early, But that pitch right there, well-executed changeup, if he can mix that in, maybe he hangs around for a little while longer.
Fouled off. The 1-2.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
The 2-2. A swing and a shot hit down the corner, and it's a foul ball. Has a look, now the pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Rosario is there. And that retires the side. In now, Luis Arraez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Grounded back up the middle. And that's out number one. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. Bases are empty, one man out. And a fastball that misses up in the zone here. It's 2-1. Good time to call the change as he swings and misses for strike two. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Speared on the dive. Excellent effort, but no chance to make the play at first. That's a base hit. Now a throw over to first, and he's back standing. Buxton, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Stepping in now, Nelson Cruz. Outside, 2-1. Runners on the move for second. Pitch inside, the throw. Not in time as he steals second. Ready on 3-1. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Good pitch, and it's full now. 3-2. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
The designated hitter, Miguel Sano.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. Now with the plate, Mitch Garver. He'll get to take his first cuts here. The 1-1 pitch. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
Paxton,
also known as Big Maple due to his Canadian roots. He was a fourth-round selection back in the 2010 first-year player draft.
Hey, when you come out of the middle rounds, you have to grind for everything, and that's exactly what this guy has done, and he has turned himself into a solid big league ball player.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, that's the kind of swing you'd like to see a guy take with the bases loaded. He's going for the downs.
And a strike three called. My gracious, what a pitch with the bases loaded, and there are two away now.
The first baseman, Matt Tipler.
Paxton comes set. I'll try to put him away here on 2-2. Swing and a liner. And this is going to get down for extra bases as that'll get two and possibly all three home. And a relay home. And the tag gets him. That ends the inning, but two runs do count on the play. Into the box now, Gary Sanchez. 2-1.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
All even now, 2-2. Now here it comes. Fastball just inside.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Digging in, Tyler Wade. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. Lifted in the air out to left field. Rosario comes on now and puts it away for the second out of the inning. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. Two out, nobody on. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
The 3-1 pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. So striding forward now, Eddie Rosario. He'll start things out against James Paxton as we get the inning underway. The 2-1 home. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Pitch on the way. Down the left field line and deep. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Popped him up. Urshela backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And here's Donaldson. 1-1. It's a fastball that misses. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. Is looked at and the count moves full.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Grounder down the line at third. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a wall. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. The head-to-head with James Paxton, he's got 8 hits in 30 at-bats. 7 strikeouts on the stat sheet as well. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out. Ready for another chance? Luis Arraez, second at bat now. He grounded out to start the home first. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Oh, and he has some trouble with it.
The center fielder, number 25.
At the plate now, Byron Buxton. Count moves to a ball and 2 strikes now. And that one misses badly. It's ball 2. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Ready now, DJ LeMahieu. He hit a 2-run jack in his first at-bat.
That last at-bat, he didn't crush that changeup for a home run, but listen, a home run is a home run. This guy's awfully strong, and he can hit it out to any part of the ballpark.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. One out here in the Yankees' third inning,
and that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge.
And
And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third. Giancarlo Stanton now 0 for 1 for him here in this one. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. And he'll try to hold up in time, but to no avail as he went around and the inning is over. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third. There's a line drive, base hit to left field.
The catcher, number 8, Mitch Garver.
At the plate, Mitch Garver. A bullet to first base. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Max Kepler. He cashed in with a two-run double his first trip to the plate.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
No dice on the knuckle curve that time. 3-1. Line drive, base hit to right. And they'll hold that runner at third as everybody moves up a base, and they're loaded with one away. So now to the plate, Eddie Rosario. Fastball here misses low, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And he popped him up. In comes Judge, but he won't get there. It falls in. One run is scored. And the second run will score as that lead has evaporated. It's now a tie game, 4 apiece.
The third baseman, number 24.
Into the box, Josh Donaldson. And there's ball two now. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Stanton giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Into the box now, Marwin Gonzalez. And we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. Inside and low, 2-1.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
2-2, here it is. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Set for the start of the fourth, ready to take his hacks again, Torres, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Meanwhile now, this ball's trouble as it looks like it'll be good for extra bases. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
The first base.
Stepping in now, Luke Voigt. Hit the other way out toward right field. Cruz is there, one away. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
Now batter.
A man at second with one down. And that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks.
Line drive to center field. That's in there. Base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's a 5-4 game. Homer Bailey enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. To the plate now, Gary Sanchez. 3-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
And a good pitch there as they come after him and the count goes full.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And the recovery throw is too late, and there are two on with one away now.
The batter, the shortstop, Tyler Wade.
In now, Tyler Wade. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two. Hit hard towards center, and that's in there. Base hit. Hicks is on his way home. He will score as they extend their lead to two.
Now batting, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
At the plate, Gio Urshela. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Throw comes in quickly here, and that'll prevent the runner at third from testing things here.
Now back. Second baseman, DJ.
So now to the plate, DJ LeMahieu. Here's a blooper out toward left center. In there, a base hit. One run scores. And the runner from second is in to score. That makes it an 8-4 ball game.
The right fielder, number 91, Aaron Judge.
Standing in now, Aaron Judge. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
Hey, the bullpen needs to step up in this situation. I got to believe the manager was hoping for way more than this.
And oh dear, that caught him full bore on the mound as it ricochets back toward the plate. Throw gets him, so they are able to get an out on an unusual play. And hopefully the pitcher's okay.
Now back.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He went down on strikes last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
No offer from Stanton. It's ball four, so he'll head down to first.
Now back.
So the bases are loaded here, two men gone, and that will bring up Gleyber Torres. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2. Skied into straightaway right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. Stepping in, Luis Arraez. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on. But you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle. And one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
Buxton ahead in the count. 3-3. Following next is Nelson Cruz. He waits on deck. 3-2 to the Twins center fielder.
3-2.
All right, let's go. Hit out towards second. That's through for a base hit. His second of the ball game. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now back, right fielder.
Into the box, Nelson Cruz. And it's 2-2 now. Fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Miguel Sano. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
The 3-1 pitch. Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats foul. The 3-2 pitch. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. Slow roller down the third baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Bonnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Now batting.
At the plate, Mitch Garver. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Two and two. Next pitch coming up here will make it an even 100 for the ball game. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Hicks going back, and he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. Digging in now for the Yankees, Luke Voit. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 1-2. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. Another 1-2 delivery. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Fouled away. Here's another 2-2. Fly ball out to right field. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Now back to center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
At the plate now, Aaron Hicks. Now, oh my, this ball is crushed. Look at it go. Gone all the way into the upper deck. Fernando Romero gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. To the plate now, Gary Sanchez. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Hit sharply on the ground, and that's through for a hit.
Now batting, shortstop, Tyler Wade.
At the plate, Tyler Wade. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. That's in there. Base hit.
The third baseman, Gio Urshela.
So now to the plate, Gio Urshela lifts it into the air to shallow center. Buxton comes on now, and he has it, one down. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here.
LeMahieu.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Back on another here as the runner scores from second.
Now back, right fielder, Aaron.
Into the box now, Aaron Judge. A good action on the two seamer there, and it's 1-2. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Pretty good spot to be in as a pitcher right now. You can go for the punch out or try to induce the ground ball to get a double play.
And he fouls this one off.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And the runner from third crosses the plate. He pulls into second safely as a run will score on the play as well.
Now back, left fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Standing in now, Giancarlo Stanton. Over at the knees, and that's the second strike.
2-2.
And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. Striding forward now is the DH, Torres. He's 2-for-3 with a home run and a double.
Torres.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 1-2.
Two ball, two strikes.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Davey Garcia will take the ball now as the new pitcher.
Number 83, Davey.
Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Digging in now, Max Kepler. Two hits in two trips for him thus far.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
A little early and now it's even at 2-2. Here it comes. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Therefore, it is Stanton, and he's got it for the first out. Ready once again, Eddie Rosario. A hit in two tries so far.
Rosario.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. And it misses 3-1 now.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters' counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. Hicks going back. Still ranging back. Gone! In now, Josh Donaldson. Fouled off. Five runs, nine hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two. So two are gone in the Twins' half of the fifth. And into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Judge is on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Randy Dobnik gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys.
Randy.
Top half of the sixth about to get started. At the plate, Luke Voit. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Now back.
Stepping into the box, Aaron Hicks. And he's looking to add on to his two RBI game from earlier.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Matty, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile. But, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Now back. Gary.
To the plate now, Gary Sanchez. One and two to the Yankees catcher. Throw over to first, and the runner back safely. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. And that'll bring up Tyler Wade. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up. A 1-1. Two out with the man at first. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. And there's a base hit on the line. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
The third baseman, Gio Urshela.
At the plate now, Gio Urshela. This is line to left. Into a slide, and he makes a great catch to retire the side. Nick Nelson is going to come on now as he's already up to 10 appearances here in the spring.
Number 79, Nick.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, so the batting order turns over now and set to go Luis Arraez. He singled his last time up. Slapped hard the opposite way, and that will fall in front of Stanton. It's a base hit. So the Twins put their leadoff hitter on to get the inning started.
The center fielder, number 25.
Into the box, Byron Buxton. Right on, but this is foul down toward the box at third. Here now the 2-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Come set, now the pitch. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no-doubt home run. So now to the plate, Nelson Cruz. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle center cut. Tough pitch to take.
Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
We got 3-2.
Miguel Sano waits on deck. Now the payoff pitch home. The bouncer to the left side. LeMahieu's got it. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Miguel Sano. He got called out on strikes his last time through. 1-1, here it comes. And he misses, 2-1.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Now a check swing, but he does manage to hold up in time, ball three.
I love the ability to hold up right there, especially with count leverage. I know you want to get aggressive in the strike zone, but he was able to notice that that wasn't his pitch.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Grounded weakly toward third. Fielded cleanly. And there's out number two. Digging in, Mitch Garver. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. The 3-1. Hit high and deep out there to left center field. Hicks going back at the track. And he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. Tyler Duffy is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 21.
Miguel Andujar is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7.
Andujar.
And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Ball 3, 3-2 now. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Long run for the center fielder. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. So now a pinch hitter set to come on as Brett Gardner's grabbed the bat and moved into the on deck circle. Can't keep the weight back and he falls behind 1-2. Now the pitch. Skied into straightaway right. And that'll take care of the pinch hitter here for out number 2. Clint Frazier will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty.
Clint Frazier.
Count still at 1-2. And now a pitch on the way. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Ottavino gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7.
Adam Ottavino.
Jorge Polanco is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the 7. One and two now.
I got to count 1-2.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Into the box, Eddie Rosario. So far, 2-for-3 in this one.
Going back to that last AB, that was the express. That was an upper 90s fastball that he turned around. So I think with this guy, you might want to try to incorporate some more off-speed pitches.
Around second, he's on his way to third.
The third baseman, number 24.
At the plate, Josh Donaldson. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. The 1-2. Seven runs on 12 hits and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
Count full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. expect another full count offering on its way. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Digging in the switch hitter, Marwin Gonzalez, who could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. A ball and two strikes to the Twins shortstop.
The count is 1-2.
Fouled away. Hit out towards second. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Yelise Chacin has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 45, Yelise
Chacin. Esteban Florio is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth.
Florio.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. The 1-2. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Ready for another shot now. Luke Voigt. Two doubles for him to this point in the game. And he looks at one in there, 1-2. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number 8. So digging in now, Aaron Hicks. It's been a nice game for him. 3 hits, including a homer to this point. 3-2 to the Yankees center fielder.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
The 3-2 pitch. Hit back up the middle. Gonzalez is there. And a close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. Jonathan Loaisiga is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 43.
Jake Cave will try and get his club back into it here as he'll pinch hit to lead off the home half of the eighth. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. Williams Astudillo will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. One out, nobody on. No contact there, and it's 1-2. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2. Lifted in the air out towards left center. After it is Hicks. And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. Nick Gordon will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here as he'll pinch hit now with one away. One out and a runner on second base. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Frazier will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number 2. Aire Adrianza will look to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner at second and two away. Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1. Ball 3. Mitch Garver would be next. And he lays off ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done. Now at the plate, Mitch Garver. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at 2-2. Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. Dakota Chalmers enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Dakota Chalmers.
All set for the start of the inning. Settling in now, Gary Sanchez. Two hits in four attempts to this point. The 1-1. Taken, strike two. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. Grounded back up the middle. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Mike Tauchman will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Bases are empty, one man out. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Now a ball sliced out of play down the left field line. The 2-2. Gio Urshela waits on deck. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hot shot to third. Donaldson's there. And there are two away now. Mike Ford will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty.
Mike Ford.
And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. Zach Britton, a southpaw standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Bottom of the inning now, stepping in, Alex Avila, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Hey. 1-2 now. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Avila has just over 100 career home runs to his credit. High and deep to center field. Hicks going back to the track, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
The left fielder, number 20, Eddie Rosario.
Into the box now, Eddie Rosario. Just got a piece of that one, perhaps shortening up now. We'll get the ball in play. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Hard sinker misses 2-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw on to first will get him, and the Twins are now down to their final out. Stepping up now, Marwin Gonzalez. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Britton pauses. Here's the 1-1.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Hit pretty well out to deep left field. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. Notch one in the score column as the runner from third crosses the plate.
Check for the win. The second baseman. Robert. Blankenhorn.
In now, Travis Blankenhorn. And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. Hicks is there, makes the catch, and the ball game is over.
Anytime you can win a game, let alone on the road, you have to feel really good about yourself. It's not easy going into that other team's ballpark and coming out with a win, but they did just that.
12-8 is the way this contest ends. So the Bronx Bombers played in an even dozen runs to come out on top today. James Paxton is the winning pitcher of record. Devin Smeltzer permitted 6 earned runs to come across in the losing effort. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 58 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.